will talk about distributed caches. In our previous videos, we talked about in-memory database, we talked about what is caching. Today, we'll talk about distributed cache. In computing, a distributed cache is an extension of the traditional concept of cache, which is used in a single local. A distributed cache may span multiple servers so that it can grow in size and in transactional capacity. So traditional cache stores data in single server, but in distributed cache it can span over multiple servers. It is mainly used to store application data residing in database and web session data. The idea for distributed caching has become feasible now because main memory has become very cheap and network cards have become very fast. So that is the main reason of having the distributed cache. Now, what is the benefit of it? So improving performance is one of the things that is needed and due to which we need distributed cache. Traditionally, there is only one local server cache which is accessed by multiple servers. But in distributed cache, multiple cache servers are available and it can be accessed. One of the ways to access it is using load balancer. Now, let's see the architecture of it. Here, as we talked, it has multiple servers. Distributed cache has multiple servers. So, a distributed cache is a system that pulls together the random access memory of multiple network and computers into a single memory data store, which is used as a data cache to provide fast access to data. While most caches are traditionally in one physical server or a hardware component, a distributed cache can grow beyond the memory limit of a single computer by linking together multiple computers, referred to as a distributed architecture or a distributed cluster, for large capacity and increased processing power. Same you can see in the diagram below. Distributed caches are especially useful in environments with high volume and load. The distributed architecture allows incremental expansion, scaling by adding more computers to the cluster, allowing the cache to grow in step with data growth. Now, what are the popular use cases for a distributed cache? First is application acceleration. Applications that rely on disk-based relational database cannot always meet today's increasing demanding transaction performance requirement. By storing the most frequent accessed data in a distributed cache, you can dramatically reduce the input-output bottleneck of disk-based system. Second benefit is storing web session data. A site may store user session data in a cache to serve as input for shopping carts and recommendations. With a distributed cache, you can have a large number of concurrent web sessions that can be accessed by any of the web application servers that are running in the system. Third is decreasing the network usage cost. By caching data in multiple places in your network, including one on the same computers as your application, you can reduce network traffic and leave more bandwidth available for the other applications that depends on the network. Fourth use case is reducing the impact of interruptions. Depending on the architecture, a cache may be able to answer data requests even when the source database is unavailable. And the last one is extreme scaling. Some applications request significant volume of data by leveraging more resources across multiple machines. A distributed cache can answer those requests. This is one of the blog that I found on Medium, which is very helpful to understand the distributed cache. A distributed cache is a cache which has data spread across several nodes in a cluster, across several clusters, or across several data centers. You can see in the below diagram the same. So why we need distributed cache system? We already have seen it is needed to achieve scalability, high availability, and fault tolerance. Business cannot afford to have these services go offline. So we need distributed cache. And how it is different, we have already seen that distributed cache is designed to scale inherently They are designed in a way such that their power can be augmented on the fly, be it compute, storage, or anything. But a traditional cache is hosted on a few instances and has a limit to it. It is hard to scale it on the fly. It is not much available and fault tolerant in comparison to the distributed cache design. And you must remember, what is the use case of distributed cache? Database caching, user session storing, and in-memory database lookup. Now let's understand how does it work. A distributed cache under the covers is a distributed hash tables which has responsibility of mapping object values to the keys spread across multiple nodes. A hash table manages the addition, deletion, failure of node continuously as long as the cache service is online. Distributed hash table were originally used in the peer-to-peer system. Speaking of the design, cache evicts data based on the least recently used policy. We'll see the eviction policy in the next step. Basically, it uses a doubly linked list to manage the data pointers, which is the most important part of the data structures. Cache enabled deletion can be done through multiple ways, like read through, write through. In the read through strategy, the data is written into the cache and the corresponding database at the same time. The schema maintains the complete data consistency between the cache and the main storage. In the write through operations, in this strategy, every information directly written to the database just by passing the cache. Cache invalidation will cover in detail in the future video. This is very important for the interview preparation as well. So today we talked about distributed cache. What is distributed cache? We understand that. So thank you viewers for watching the video, and if you think video is helpful, please like the video and subscribe to the channel. And if you want us to make video on other topics, please write in the comment box. Thank you so much for watching.